legends. I hope you're all fantastic. On today's video, we're going to talk about this magic little yellow box, the bridge from Elk Live. On the surface, it just kind of looks like a nice little slimline interface. You've got two combi jacks on the front, headphone outputs on the back. You've got monitor outs, you've got power, you've got a USB output so you can use it as an audio interface. You've got ADAT in, MIDI via TRS, and very interestingly, an Ethernet port on here. The reason is that this is actually tailored to low latency online jamming. So unlike a lot of other solutions which use servers and you've got to use your own audio interface, the servers are going to add latency, the audio interface is going to add latency. We have tried it. We spent like every week during the pandemic trying to make stuff like Jam Kazam work. This bypasses that by just going peer-to-peer via Ethernet. So you have your Ethernet connection on here. You plug whatever you want to plug into here. There are mic preamps in here as well, which is super handy. And then you use the Elk Online. It's a web-based app to kind of hook up with your bandmates and get about the business of jamming. I want to give you a very quick little demo of how this actually works. And then I'll just kind of talk about my first impressions and what I've been using it for. So let's go. In order to actually set up a jam, you use the web-based app with your bridge. So I've plugged my vocal mic into input one on the bridge. I've got my guitar going to my AxeFX, which is coming out into the second input of the bridge. And I've got an Ethernet connection to the bridge. I've also got an Ethernet connection going to my computer. I could be using Wi-Fi on the computer as long as they are coming from the same core connection. And you can see up here that my bridge is now connected. And I've got this backstage area here. You can see the other two guys aren't online, but this is where you would add people to collaborate with and then create sessions. You can also set up video, which I'm not going to do at the moment because I'm using my camera right now to actually film myself here. But what's really cool is you've got this mixer section over here. So for myself, I would use this to actually set up the input. So you can see over here, I've got two inputs here. If I want to manage the gain levels on either of them, I can do that in here. I can set up the type of input. I've got a mic on channel one and my line input for my guitar. Over there, so I can set up all the gain levels there. So that is just purely managing the input of the device. I can now close this, and this little section here is what I'm gonna hear. Now, I don't really need to hear my own voice, so I could actually turn that down in my headphones, but I do want to hear my guitar, so I can set that up and I can pan this. You know, if I had multiple instruments or if I had stereo guitars coming in here, I could pan them accordingly. When I do a jam session though, anybody who's jamming with me is gonna get these two different inputs and they can set them wherever they like. It's essentially like a pre-fader send on a mixer. They're getting these separate aux outputs. They can do whatever they want with them. If they don't want to hear my voice, they don't have to hear it either. For jams, obviously, if I'm talking to the other guys in the band, I want to be able to hear them. I don't really want to hear my own voice in my headphones, though. If Ryan's singing, though, he's going to want to hear his own voice in his headphones, so he can do that. When everybody else logs in, I will get, say, Cam over here, I'll get Ryan over here, and I can do my own mix for my own headphones. So it's like having your own custom in-ears feed. Everybody gets their own custom feed. You can set your levels independent of one another. That is one touch that I really like that some of the other like online jam apps that I have tried before don't let you do. It's like everyone's on the same send and you're kind of just riding the input gain on your channel to get what you need to do. So that's kind of how the Elk Live app works together with the bridge. Now we need to actually hear it in action. Okay, I can see that Cam is online. I'm just simply going to hit start new session and we can go. We can try my guitar sound while we wait. All right, Cam, are you there?
Yes, how you going?
Awesome. Yeah, awesome. All right, let's do this. Let's make some magic. All right, first little test will just be to see if we can actually play in time. So give me some snare cam. So well, like just being able to like actually lock, you know,
yeah.
I feel like with Jam Kazam and some of the other stuff we tried, it was like you would have to play and not listen.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like you're not really jamming, you're just operating.
No, it's good, man. Now, like honestly, with the stereo drums, this is like mint. Really, really cool.
Yeah.
Very impressed.
Awesome. All right. We'll do some more.
All right. Sounds good.
As you probably guess, my overall first impressions with this unit are very positive. Just the fact that it works, just the fact that we were able to jump online, start jamming, and didn't have to fight internet latency on there. It actually felt really good, and it felt like I could lock in with the drums, which are always the hardest thing about any rehearsal, whether it's with a full band, whether it's like a silent style rehearsal with V-drums, which we've done a lot, or whether it's now with the Elk Live. You just get that smile on your face when you finally crack apart. We used all of our Elk units, all in separate locations, to rehearse for the recent acoustic show we did opening for John Karabi. That involved a lot of rearranging of parts and just being able to be in my space, you know, space that I'm comfortable with. I feel like made that a whole lot easier, a lot smoother, and we had a lot of really good ideas because we weren't on the clock. Now, there are some hardware I/O features which aren't online just yet. The ADAT stuff isn't working at the moment. I believe MIDI is either just about to come online or it has just come online, but that is stuff Elk have said they are actively developing. And obviously there is a subscription involved. If you look at the price of a subscription, whether yearly or monthly, you know, say you looked at the monthly subscription for three guys in a band, 1 month for the whole band is about what you would pay for a single 6 to 8 hour slot in a rehearsal studio. And obviously you've got to go to the rehearsal studio, set up all your gear, do the rehearsal, tear it all down, and then go home, which is going to take up a bunch of extra time. With this, I found it was just super convenient to log on whenever we had a spare minute. And for someone like Ryan, our singer and bass player, you know, he's got a family, he's got kids. That is a big commitment. I've got a bunch of stuff going on. Cam's got a bunch of stuff going on. Finding that time during the week to actually get together and collaborate, this definitely makes it a lot easier. We do have some shows coming up in August where we're playing interstate. So we're going to spend the month of July doing all our rehearsals and we're going to use this a whole bunch. I will take some more clips with the Elk Live there and I will do an updated video in the future. For now, I want to know your thoughts on this unit. Is this something you would be interested in? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Again, a massive thank you to Bjorn and the whole team at Elk for making this video possible. If you want to support what I do here on the channel, there's some links in the video description. I hope you all have a fantastic day and I'll see you next time.